back to me.
Yes.
You know, the closer we get, the more I'm remembering. Probably best I leave you to it. Simply stick to the path and keep a sharp eye out for that birdbath. Adieu. Is that Latin? Or Greek?
Nothing to do now but keep going. The waterfall. For a thief, Jackdaw's surprisingly as good as his word. Something oddly solemn about this place. Such regal creatures, stags. There it is. Just as Jackdaw described. Intramuros.
Eventually lead us to whatever it is you're hiding.
Well, those loyalists will report back to Ranrok now. Let's see where Jackdaw has led me. I wonder how big this place is. Stay lit for long. Impressive. That must be where all this leads. Someone didn't want casual visitors down here. I wonder if any of my spells miss. I'm not gonna touch those. platform ought to be able to float straight to me. Richard Jackdaw left a little something behind for me, but where could... skeleton in sight. But I may as well help myself to this. Perhaps the next symbol is hidden somewhere.
Revelio. Incendio!
It's a good thing Jackdaw didn't fall down there.
Accio!
I'd have thought Jackdaw would have been interested in this loot, but there's no sign of him.
Incendio!
Untouched chest. Jackdaw wasn't very thorough in his search of this cave.
Incendio! Accio! Levioso! Revelio! Revelio. Incendio.
I'm glad Richard Jackdaw left a little something behind for me, but... Not a headless skeleton in sight. But I may as well help myself to this.
Accio!
An untouched chest. Thorough in his search of this cave. That's odd. I'd have thought Jackdaw would have been interested in this loot, but there's no sign of him.
Revelio.
There it is. The bridge, it's almost complete. More spiders. This can't be bad.
Accio.
Incendio.
Leviosa.
Imagine how many have multiplied since Jackdaw came this way. I'm glad Richard Jackdaw left a little something behind for me. Where could he be? Must be getting closer to Jackdaw's remains and those pages. We meet again, Richard Jackdaw. Thank you for keeping these pages safe all these years. Here it is, the map that brought your doom, Jackdaw. Is there something beyond this room? unnerving. What's happening?
Revelio. Revelio.
I saw this before. Gringotts and a restricted section. Where am I? Oh no! The room's starting to flood. How am I being protected? What sort of magic is this? I can only hope this magic protects me until I'm able to make my way out of it. What is this place?
Can it be?
It's you.
Has someone finally found our map chamber?
I recognize you from the Pensives. You're Professor Rackham.
I am indeed. I must confess that I am surprised to see someone so young standing before me.
I'm the same age that you and Isadora Morganarch were when you started at Hogwarts.
You've paid attention. And might I presume you share our ability?
To see traces of ancient magic? Yes, sir, I do.
As you have likely realized by now, our ability gives us a unique relationship with all forms of magic. We can access expressions of magic that few others can. Opportunities will arise that allow you to sharpen this rare talent. Do not squander them.
I won't, Professor. Thank you.
We have much to discuss. But first, a map found in a certain book led you here. Place the book on the pedestal.
I don't have the book with me, sir.
That is unfortunate. I'm afraid we must pause our conversation until you return with the book.
Very well. I'll retrieve the book right away.
Good. We shall speak again once the book is in place.
Incendio!
I found the pages and the map chamber. Why would I need the book? I'm back at Hogwarts. I wonder when Professor Fig will be back. I did promise him I wouldn't go back to study his books away. Suppose I have enough to distract myself with till he returns with the book.
I've always said that travel...
...to learn the Pulso, the banishing charm. Useful for pushing objects or adversaries away. Complete the required tasks and meet me in my classroom.
We have everything a young student might need when it comes to potions. Have a good look around. Very good. Never hurts to keep my stocks replenished. I hope to see you again. Farewell for now.
It was an accident!
What do you want?
Here. Everybody grab a broom, and we shall get started. Mr. Clopton, your attention, please.
Thank you.
Now, your turn.
Up, 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 you stupid ratty school broom!
One leg over, so there's a leg on each side. None of that side saddle nonsense. A gust of wind will throw you right off. Good. Now, for your first lesson, fly through each ring in the courtyard. Do take care. The brooms are school property. I want them returned in one piece.
Own broom. This is brilliant.
Well done. Now that you're acclimatized to your broom. This next set of rings will take you around the grounds for more of a challenge.
What a view!
Hello! Nice day for a flight!
This is rather fun.
Ah, the old boathouse. Wish you could have experienced crossing the lake as the first year.
Whoa, our aquatic resident likes to make an appearance once in a while.
Made it! Oh, did anyone else see that?
Oh, well done! Have a moment!
I say, I watched you fly through those rings. You seem to handle yourself on that dusty school broom well enough. I'd imagine you're ready for something a bit more challenging. But I'm getting ahead of myself. We haven't properly met. I'm Everett Clopton. Am I right in suspecting that a Slytherin like you might be interested in making an escape from class?
Can't say no to that. What did you have in mind?
A bit of a detour, so to speak. Follow me. The tour is about to begin. Follow closely now.
Right now, we're flying over the Transfiguration Courtyard. Lovely as ever.
Let's hope the headmaster isn't having tea by the window today.
Nice to get above it all, isn't it? Ahead are the gardens. The Hufflepuff common room windows just peek out. Bit claustrophobic for my taste.
How is Everett flying so quickly?
Here's something handy to know. Lean forward for a burst of speed. Helpful if you need to escape a tricky situation.
That's a bit of solid architecture, isn't it?
That's more like...
flying tips and...
Are you sure you're not part hippogriff?
This is quite the tall Everett.
That's Kagawa's whistle. This concludes our tour. Let's hurry back.
In our brooms. Dismount here.
And where have you two been?
Oh, hello, Professor. We were trying to get a bit of extra practice in.
Hefty points will be taken from each of you for not following my instructions. Mr. Clopton, I'm disappointed in you. You're in this class because you're still... Because you're still not showing yourself, or frankly, your broom, the proper respect.
But, Professor...
Enough! Class is finished for the day. As for you, you do well to use better judgment in the future. Chin up. That was some rather good flying.
Sorry about that business with Kagawa, but you have to admit, those views were worth it.
It was worth losing a few house points for that detour.
You seem at home on a broom. Bet if you had a fancy model, you could fly laps around Imelda. She's Kagawa's favorite. I could show her a thing or two if I had my own broom. Hate having to return the school broom after class.
Perhaps I'll have to purchase a broom, then.
If you can, you should. Wish I could. I recommend visiting Albie Weeks at Spintwitch's in Hogsmeade. He's always looking to test new models. I'll keep an eye out for you in the sky.
I've not forgotten about our library venture. How did you fare? If you're keen for some illicit...
Rebellion!
Meet me outside the Defense Against the Dark Arts classroom. I know a discreet place near there.
Rebellion!
Meet me in the 7th floor corridor as soon as you can. I have an idea for somewhere you can focus on your studies. Eyes and distractions.
There you are. The Crosswands duelist to beat.
I asked to meet Takar to tutor me in Transfiguration, but he refused. I'm a lost cause.
I'm not taking my chances with unauthorized games. I've had enough encounters with Scalagro, thank you.
Don't tell me one little arm break and you're already out. It was only an experimental maneuver, that was all.
Don't trust him. He only tries to get everyone injured because he likes having a chat with Melanie.
That is true. Fascinating tales she's got. You want to get her telling you about bewitched big toes. Ugh, it's chilling.
I'm not scared of bewitched big toes. My injuries were serious, not for idle banter over cups of tea.
Tell us about your injuries, then. Go on.
Well, I will. I'm not hiding them. fun to listen to. Funny that. Last I heard, you'd been bitten by an enchanted bee and had a buzzing. A buzzing extremity is nothing to joke about. I beg to differ.
Nice to see you.
Yeah. Oh.
There you are. The Cross One's duelist to beat.
I'd like to retire to Hogsmeade one day. Open a pub. Four future Hogwarts pupils with tales of my childhood.
I should like to retire to a small hamlet when I'm older. One just like Brockborough.
Any news about the dragon you hit upon fall? Be enough to make me move, to be honest.
I adore the hamlets near the coast. They're a bit damp, but ever so picturesque.
Having a pleasant time at school.
Look attentive in potions seems to keep sharp on the back. It works quite well unless he asks me a question, and then it's not really good for at all. Overall, I probably wouldn't recommend it.
I don't find potions bearable at all. And if it's double potions, I question whether I wouldn't just rather be a muggle.
I heard some chatter near the girls' laboratory about boom slats. Do you think they're looking to brew a polyjuice potion?
Oh, what if they already brew?
And Sharp's actually that Hufflepuff girl with the long arms.
Why are we only learning all the boring potions? When are we learning Felix Felicis? Knowing Sharp, he'll probably teach it after we've done our exams.
Try riding a hippogriff. You will soon learn that Kagawa's techniques are lacking practical uses.
There you are. The Cross One's duelist to beat.
Nothing creates a bond like thinking you're all about to die.
I wonder what Kagawa did.
Was it? Flabbergasted leech.
Over here.
Sebastian, it's been a while.
It has.
First, let me thank you for what you did in the library.
Of course.
Well, you took the fall for me.
Did you find what you were looking for?
I did.
Understood. We can talk more in a moment, in the Undercroft. Not even the professors know about this place. This way. There's a secret passage just here.
It's well disguised. How did you find this place?
My friend, Ominous Gaunt. He named it the Undercroft. We used to play golf stones here all the time. With my sister, Anne. She loved that infernal game. What I wouldn't give to lose to her again. I should tell you, I swore to Ominous I would safeguard this place. So please, keep this between us. He never confides in anyone. But he's trusted me since the day we met. I wouldn't want to jeopardize that. We used to sneak in here almost daily. We've never been caught. Revelio.
I know Ominous. Met him in our common room. I've noticed he uses his wand to navigate the castle.
He does. No idea how, though. Ominous was born blind, and no spell could reverse it. His wand seems almost sentient. Not surprising, I suppose. Ollivander always says, the wand chooses the wizard.
Is that how he found this place?
No, someone in his family knew about it. The Gaunts are full of secrets. I've never heard anyone else speak of it, and I've certainly never seen anyone else here. Again, mention this to no one, especially Ominous. He has no love lost for his family or their secrets, but this place is special to him.
Of course. Ominous spoke to me about his family when we first met. To say that he has no love lost for them is an understatement.
Glad you understand. Anyway, the Undercroft has been a perfect place to sneak off to, away from prying eyes, and even practice otherwise forbidden spells.
Really? Like what?
Like the Blasting Curse. Professors say it's not an appropriate spell to teach students.
A proper magical education ought to include all magic.
My thoughts exactly. A spell like Confringo is only truly dangerous in untrained hands. Such spells should be properly taught, not banned. To be fair, I'm admittedly partial to more fiery forms of magic, but you should learn it. I can teach it to you safely here. It may take a while to get the feel for it. Mimic my wand movement. The incantation is Confringo.
Very well.
You're getting it. Ready to actually try it out? Stick to the targets, though. Best
Revelio
intact. Have a go at those candelabras. Both have their uses, but I think you'll find that a Confringo cast travels a bit farther than that of a spell like Incendio. Nice work. How's it feel?
It's a tad hot.
You'll get used to it. That's it.
I think I've got it.
Well done.
I have to say, I enjoyed that.
The first time Ominous and I practiced Confringo. We singed our eyebrows.
I would have paid to see that.
I swore we'd never live it down. So this day, there's something about that spell that's addictive.
The blast does heat things up. I see how you lost your eyebrows.
You'll get used to it. Anne Ominous and I used to practice down here for hours. The Undercroft was our retreat. Haven't been here in some time. It's not the same without Anne.
I'm sorry about your sister. If there's anything I can do...
Perhaps when I next head to Feldcroft, you could come along. Meet Anne. She could use some cheering up.
Just let me know when and I'll meet you.
Ah, she misses Hogwarts. She's been stuck at home with our guardian, Uncle Solomon. Unfortunately, you'll have to meet him too. Well, meeting a new student will be precisely what she needs.
I shall look forward to it.
Cheers. By the way, what was it you couldn't discuss out in the hall earlier?
I'm not sure where to start.
You said something was missing from what you found in the library. I assume it's to do with what you told me. About the portkey, and Gringotts, and Ranrock.
Nothing gets past you. And yes, it is. As I'm sure you suspect, there is a bit more to all of this.
I'm listening.
You must promise to keep this between us.
I trusted you with knowledge of this secret Undercroft. You can trust me.
All right. I can see traces of ancient magic.
Ancient magic? I don't know what I was expecting you to say, but it wasn't that. What does that even mean?
Honestly, I'm not entirely certain. All I know is that I can see whispers of an old magic that hardly anyone else can. Fig and I think that Ranrock has somehow found a way to harness that magic's power.
Are you telling me that goblins may be wielding some sort of wizard magic?
That's what we're trying to find out.
And this ability of yours, does this allow you to wield this magic too?
I don't know.
Well, when you do know, tell me. I've been studying archaic forms of magic for ages. Perhaps we can help each other. In the meantime, with both Rookwood and Ranrock after you, I suspect a bit more time practicing the blasting curses in order. Spend as much time here as you'd like. And remember, keep this place between us. When I head to Feldcroft, I'll send you an owl.
Hello, Sebastian. Wait. You there? I can hear you.
Hello, Ominous. I was just heading to our common room.
I've recognized that voice. You're the new fifth year. Did you just come from the Undercroft? How did you get in there?
That room's called the Undercroft. Ah, well, I was exploring and then suddenly found myself in a strange passageway.
Don't lie to me. No one stumbles upon that room. Sebastian told you, didn't he? You breathe a word about this place to anyone. Not even your precious Professor Fig will be able to help you. My father is friends with the headmaster. I am not afraid to exploit that connection if I need to.
You needn't threaten me. I'm not going to say anything about your Undercroft. And Sebastian is a good friend. You shouldn't immediately assume the worst of him.
I don't need you to tell me about my oldest friend. Thank you very much.
Ominous, I just meant...
I know what you meant! Sebastian gets himself in enough trouble. He doesn't need your help. Sebastian is going to get an earful about this.
Professor Weasley?
Somewhere away from prying eyes.
Forgive me, the headmaster stopped me and I... Merlin's beard! I see you've wasted no time. Well done. Shall we?
Off to you, Professor. What is this place?
This is the Room of Requirement. It only appears when one is in real need of it. Ordinarily, a student might stumble upon this room entirely by accident. If ever. I'd only planned to suggest to you how to find it by walking past that bit of wall, focusing on what you need. But you've managed to reveal the room on your own. While I'm here, we should take advantage of the moment. Now, where is Deke? He must have sneaked past and gone ahead.
Deke, Professor?
The house elf I was speaking to in my classroom your first day. Thought he might help you use the room once you found it. There's no chance I'm clambering over this mess. This presents the perfect opportunity to teach you Evanesco, the vanishing spell. You can cast Evanesco to vanish certain objects, such as these chairs and other things here in the room. I suggest you practice the wand movements first, then you can clear the chairs away. Splendid. Cast Evanesco on... Excellent work. You'll note that you are now in possession of Moonstone. We shall discuss its uses later. Let's move on. Where in the world is that elf? Is that... goodness. My old school bag. I wondered where that had got to. Can't believe it's still here. I'll just take a quick look at this. Give you an opportunity to explore on your own until we locate Deke.
Yes, Professor.
Dear me. Can't you keep it down? Some of us are trying to rest.
Revelio!
Hope this isn't as precarious as it looks.
An intruder! Stop them! No, not... that's not helpful, you worthless pile of tin!
Revelio! Revelio. Incendio. Revelio.
How does anyone other than a house elf manage to get around in here? Golden Stitch.
Perhaps you should summon your wits and find out.
Incendio. Accio. Revelio. I hope that house elf can find us in there. Yikes! Careful!
Huh?
Oh, there you are! Wait right there. Deke will come to you. Hello.
Ah, Deke. We've been looking for you.
Apologies, Professor Weasley. Deke was looking through some of what's appeared in the room since Deke was last here. Is this the student? The Room of Requirement. It's unplottable, so won't appear on any map. Most habitable. Deke seen students in the... You...
I was thinking about needing a place away from prying eyes. Brilliant.
Oh, that explains it then.
What I need specifically...
Now, it's time to focus on what you need. Just close your eyes. Imagine the room precisely as you need it. The room will do the rest.
Given yourself quite a canvas to work with. I look forward to seeing what you do with the space. Ah, and it seems the room has provided you with a desk of description. Excellent. It can identify unfamiliar items of clothing. One should always understand the effects of anything in which one is clothed. You'll find plenty of items of clothing that need to be identified. The desk will be an invaluable resource.
I imagine the desk of description will come in handy.
It will. I hope you'll take advantage of it. Now, I'll give you a brief lesson in conjuring. The room might not provide everything you need on its own.
Conjuring?
Yes, the magic of creating or conjuring objects. I'll teach you. Very good. When conjuring more complex objects, you'll need what's called a spellcraft. Spellcrafts are like recipes. They list the ingredients or resources needed to conjure a particular object. You should have acquired some for a potion station and potting table from tomes and scrolls in Hogsmeade.
I did. Where can I find the resources I need?
While resources such as moonstone can be obtained throughout the Highlands, it's much safer and easier to purchase them. They can also be collected by vanishing objects in the room, such as the chairs you vanished earlier. In fact, you should have enough resources for now.
I see. Can I regain
You can indeed. Quite perceptive. Why don't you give it a try? Go ahead and conjure the potion station and potting table. You should find both familiar, since they'll resemble the ones you've already used to study magical plants and brew potions in class. You can use these whenever you need to brew potions or grow plants. Presuming, of course, you've collected any seeds or potion ingredients you need in Hogsmeade or outside the castle grounds. Here to answer any questions you may have. Do not underestimate his insights.
I will be sure to speak with Deke if I need anything. Thank you.
Good luck. I shall linger a bit longer in case you'd like to learn another transfiguration spell for use in the room.
Deke thinks you should be proud of all the potions you've brewed.
Rather unproductive trip to the ministry, hoping your time has been more fruitful than mine.
Deke hasn't seen this many plants here before.
Wingardium Leviosa. It can be used to levitate objects for a short time. Once you've completed a few prerequisite tasks, do see me after class.
You should be proud of all the potions you've brewed. Deke hasn't seen this many plants here before. I cannot believe how many beasts you have here.
More to teach you about transfiguration.
Deke thinks you should be proud of all the potions you've brewed. Hasn't seen this many plants here before.